Let's take a look at the solution to this. It's a little bit tricky. Firstly, at the top of our file, we declare two new variables, frame rate and frame. Now, frame rate represents how often we'd like to actually call the animate function. Frame is a variable that we're going to use to represent what the current frame in our flipbook is. Since we already have our frames array available, the next step is to actually loop through our predefined assets and load each of the defined images into the frames array. This follows the same three-step process we saw before. Create a new image, set its onload result, and then set its source. Once this is done, we can actually call the setInterval function, which will call the animate function at the frame rate that we provided before. Now, the animate function has a little bit of tricky logic inside of it. First off, we have our frame counter that we've defined. We use this to define what image out of the frames array we have to draw to the canvas, and of course, at our lovely position of 192 by 192. Once we've drawn the current frame, we actually have to increment it, and that's where this little nice piece of math comes along. What we do is increment the frame counter and then modulo it by the frame's length. What will occur here is that if frame ever becomes longer than frame length, the modulo function will have it loop around back to zero without us having to have all the other if statements involved. This is a nice little piece of math that you should put in your code. Your employer will be impressed by it. Now, if you followed all the code, you should see something like this running around on the screen. If you'll notice something, this doesn't exactly look right. You actually get each of the frames drawn over each other, creating this sort of halo effect. There's a reason for this. It's worth noting that the canvas doesn't actually clear itself each frame. Instead, it allows you to just keep piling pixels on it as you go. In order to get rid of that ghosting effect, you have to put this line that we've conveniently left out of our previous function back in, and that is context.clearRect. What this will do is actually clear all of the pixels to some default value, allowing us to draw back on top of it, so you won't get the previous images actually drawn on top of each other. The result is a nice, nifty walking robot running around on your screen, just like it should. The result with clearRect is this nice, fancy walking robot.